We've all used rubber mats in our house, but have you ever wondered how rubber mats are made? How are they so rigid and tough?
What better place to find out than a rubber mat factory?
The basic components required for a mat formation is natural rubber, synthetic rubber, then tire powder. Actually, this is all these three are formed into a compound, then it is brought into a dispersion aider.
The first or the basic step in preparation of a rubber mat starts with the formation of a compound. A compound is made out of synthetic rubber, natural rubber, tire powder, and certain chemicals. The compounds or the raw materials are then added to the dispersion kneader by a worker. The worker, in timely intervals, also adds other ingredients like black oil and other certain chemicals. The thick black mass of rubber produced from the dispersion kneader is taken to the next step or the sheeting process. The sheeting process happens at high temperatures which require constant water injection to keep the machines cool. We are midway through the process of making a rubber mat. The next stage involves the hydraulic press where the worker loads the rubber sheets onto the hydraulic press.
The cherry on the cake in this process is the punching press. After that, we take it directly to the quality check.
The hot rubber mats out of the hydraulic press lack any texture or print. It is at the punching press where the rubber mat takes its final shape. The final stage involves the quality check. A worker flips and rolls the mat to check for any inconsistencies. The state of Kerala accounts for 90% of India's natural rubber production. Of late, natural rubber has faced severe competition from synthetic or artificial rubber. How has the coronavirus pandemic affected the rubber industry and its prospects?
The impact of coronavirus has been on two fronts. The export charges or the transportation cost has risen, and which has made most of the exports expensive. It has also affected the imports as raw material prices are going very high, which is making life very difficult.
Rubber is to Kerala what oil is to Saudi Arabia. Given all the apprehensions of the coronavirus pandemic, entrepreneurs like Alan are still optimistic of the rubber market and its future prospects given the increased demand in countries in North America and Europe. This is Matthew Jacob for ACJ TV.